Love isn't love until you give it away. My dear brothers and sisters, today as we celebrate the 15th Sunday of the year, we get a reflection from the Gospel according to Mark, chapter 6, verses 7 to 13. There is a beautiful poem by Oscar Hammerstein that says, "A bell is not a bell until you ring it. A song is not a song until you sing it. And love in your heart wasn't put there to stay. Love isn't love until you give it away." My dear brothers and sisters, the poem reminds us that a certain thing will find its true meaning when it is used for that particular purpose for which it was made. In our basic catechism, we are told that man was created by God to know Him, to love Him, to serve Him, and to be happy with Him in heaven. Suffice it to say that if we do not strive to know God, to love Him, to serve Him, and to be with Him, then our life is devoid of meaning. In the first reading, the prophet Amos, who was a herdsman and dresser of sycamore trees, was financially secure and was content in his job or trade. But he was called by God to prophesy to the people of Israel. He is referred to by some biblical scholars as the reluctant prophet. He experienced conflicts with government authorities. He was rejected, but these did not stop him from prophesying. Rather, he performed his prophetic ministry with courage and zeal, all done in response to God's command, fulfilling the purpose of his calling. Jesus in the Gospel today sent the 12 for mission, two by two. He gave them the authority over evil spirits, and he laid out to them the do's and don'ts in their missionary life. He forewarned them of rejections and persecutions. They are supposed to trust in divine providence and must be resolute in proclaiming about repentance. My dear brothers and sisters, the call to become missionaries is not only for a few. Our beloved Pope Francis, in his apostolic exhortation, Evangelii Gaudium, says, and I quote, "In virtue of their baptism, all the members of the people of God have become missionary disciples. Every Christian is a missionary to the extent that he or she has encountered the love of God in Christ Jesus. We no longer say that we are disciples and missionaries, but rather that we are always missionary disciples." Unquote. This is the meaning and the purpose of our baptismal calling: to serve and to love our Lord as missionary disciples. Some of us might be tempted to ask, how can I be a missionary disciple when I am weak, I am inadequate, I am unworthy? It is good to acknowledge our inadequacies, our ineptness, our unworthiness, and present all of this before the Lord. But all at the same time, or at the same time, we trust in the power and grace of God to work in us, to use us as His instruments. We are reminded time and again by our Holy Father to believe in the principle of the primacy of grace, bearing in mind that the salvation which God offers us is a work of His mercy. Mission is God's initiative. Ours is to cooperate with His grace so that the work of evangelization may bear much fruit. Another question that might pop up in this context is, how can we possibly do this in the midst of the lingering pandemic, when health protocols and restrictions continue to limit our movements and prevent us from gathering for catechetical classes, formation sessions, and the like? Perhaps you have heard this saying already, that the pandemic should not paralyze us. We strive to do our part, to give our best. We survive, and eventually we continue to thrive. Just as the song Amare et Servire says, in everything, love and serve the Lord. Each of us should find ways to communicate Jesus, wherever we are and whatever we do. Particularly in this age of social media, when we have different gadgets that can become powerful means of evangelization and of proclamation, if only we use them properly and with good and holy intentions. And there are various platforms available. We are called to become digital missionaries or missionaries in the cyberspace. Recently, I have had a meeting with several young volunteers who help in the digital communications ministry of the Archdiocese of Cebu. I am happy that we have such dedicated and promising digital missionaries who are gifted with creativity and so much talent, who are helping us to reach out to so many people in the cyberspace. But we, all of us who have access to Facebook or Instagram or TikTok, the challenge is, how can we use them or these platforms to proclaim the goodness of the Lord, to bring hope to people that Jesus is merciful? How can we be missionaries with all of these? While others make use of the social media to spread fake news, half-truths, or to destroy the reputation of others, we who are Christians are missionary disciples and must do our best to make use of these inventions to give hope, to inspire, to encourage, to share God's love, mercy, and compassion. And as we do this together with St. Paul in his letter to the Ephesians, we acknowledge, blessed be God, the Father of our Lord, who in Christ has blessed us from heaven with every spiritual blessing. We who bear the name of Christ in our identity as Christians, may we truly live up to our name by being other Christs, by continuing his mission of bringing the good news to everyone. And as the song for this year of mission goes, totally yours we give ourselves, faithfully yours until the end. To your mission, Lord, we give our yes. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.